Hello everyone, welcome to the Financial Information Channel. My name is Marvin. In this video, I'm going to give you the stock news that happened between May 29 to June 2nd. In addition, I'm going to do the earnings to watch from June 5th to June 9th. Let's start with the video. And before I start the video, please write down in the comment section what was your best investment during the month of May and what happened to that stock. Are you still optimistic for June and going forward, or do you end up selling the stock or you end up getting more shares? It would be nice to know that information. In addition, make sure that you check out the video. I'm doing a giveaway right here. You can click on the video, and that giveaway is really simple to enter. All you have to do is put a comment and you're gonna be entered into the giveaway. Now let's start with the video. And the first company that I predicted was Box. I predicted that the company was going to beat the EPS and the revenue, and it beat both. It beat the EPS by 1 cent and the revenue by 2.26 million. But the most important thing is they gave a good guidance. I'm gonna put that in the screen. And the thing that I saw the most was that the billing is gonna grow 31% for the next year. So let me go over the billing, what it means. Billing means when it's a recurring payment. It's kind of like some of the stocks have subscription-based services. Let me give an example. Let me say that you're investing into Adobe. You're paying a subscription to use Photoshop or any of those programs. And that is how some companies continue generating more income, which is always a good thing. Now, the company is still not profitable because I think it came out in 2015 and it had a lot of debt. However, right now they're really getting closer to having no debt at all. And this company has gone up quite a bit amount just for this year. It has gone up 44%. Now, the stock is still trading under 20, so it's a little bit cheap. However, their PE is a little bit high at this moment. I would say that you hold it because there are so many companies that I feel are a little bit overvalued. Now, this company is actually generating some revenue and it has a positive outlook, but I would just wait. And the next company was Ollie's, and I predicted that it was gonna go in EPS. However, it was gonna go down in revenue. And the company actually beat the EPS by 2 cents and the revenue by 6.69 million. Now, I'm not very familiar with this company, but from what I have read is that they sell a lot of low price products. And that is one of the strategies that some retailers do so they don't get hit a lot by Amazon. Now, the stock has gone up 50% for the year. That's a huge amount. I would say hold because I think the stock might pull back at some point. I still wouldn't invest into a retailer at this moment. Especially Ollie's, I don't know that well their business. Now, I would invest into a retailer that I don't have any clue. Like this Ollie's, for example, it's not that their business is not growing up. It's that I need to do a lot of research before I start investing into a company. So I only predicted half for this company. Now, the next company is Palo Alto Networks. Now, in the last video, I said that this company was at 1.190 and the value went down a huge amount. Now, I think this was a key report for this company, and I predicted that it was going to go up in EPS and revenue, and it crushed the numbers. It beat the EPS by 6 cents and it got a revenue boost of 19.66 million. Now, this company might have a bright future. I still, at this moment, I still need to do a lot of research more. However, the outlook looks very bright. And let me explain why. From the reports that I have read, is that the security market is gonna be 100 billions by 2020. And during this third quarter, they grew the revenue by 25%. Now the revenue was a little bit down compared to billing on this company. However, I think the billing is the most important thing when looking at this type of company. And billing, like I mentioned before, is a recurring payment. So billing, in my opinion, is a way that they're gonna generate more money into that company. So the 52-week high was 166, I believe, and around this time is almost 140 for each chair. I would say that this company is gonna be going to 150 at least, because they actually did report a good report for this quarter. And I think in the last week video, they were negative for the year. However, after that report, they're around 10% for 2017. So I got both of those right, that I predicted the EPS and the revenue. Now, the next company is Broadcom. Now, Broadcom beat the EPS by 19 cents and the revenue by 90 million. And I predicted that this company was going to beat both, and it did. And it has gone up almost 44% for the year. And that's what I mean. Most of the semiconductor stocks are going really, really high this year. So this company is a solid choice. The only thing is the price for each chair is a little bit high. Each chair is over $250. You could invest into something more solid, in my opinion, with that type of money. Now, the next company is another retailer, and that was Five Below. And I predicted that it was going to go in EPS and revenue, and it did them both. It beat the EPS by 1 cent, and it went up in revenue by 2.24 million. Now, I was reading a lot of articles, and I saw that they actually had a positive sales on the fidget spinners. And the fidget spinners are actually one of the things that drove a lot of revenue through the store. However, they sell a lot of products that are very cheap. They have the similar way of getting revenue than Ollie's. However, this company, I think, is more popular than Ollie's, at least to me. And I would say, read these financials for this company, because the financials are clean for this company. Now, the company has gone up 30% for the year, and it has gone down 20% less than Ollie's, but I think this is a more safe choice than Ollie's, in my opinion. It's sometimes that even if you report good earnings, that doesn't guarantee that the stock is gonna go up. And the last stock that I predicted was Lululemon, and I predicted that it was gonna go down in EPS and revenue, and it actually went up the opposite. It beat the EPS by 4 cents and the revenue by 6.38 million. Now, I heard that they were expanding in Europe and Asia, but I think that's a mistake, because more stores mean more cost, and they have to drive customers to their stores. And even with the huge win in the earnings, the company is still down for the year. It is down over 16% for the whole year. And this is a retail store that sells athletic outwear. Athletic clothes is a tough business now. And one of the things is that they sell those type of clothes at a higher price. That is a huge risk, you know, when you start investing into a company that sells a lot of clothes at a higher price. Just look at most of the retailers. And now we're going to take a look at what is going to happen next week for this earnings to watch part. And now I'm going to predict the companies that are going to report next week, and if they're going to be the EPS and the revenue. And the first company is Thor Industries. They actually had an awful report last quarter, and now they're actually down over 6% for the year. And this is an opportunity, just like Palo Alto had last week. This quarter, they have to report positive results. And I think the company will report positive EPS and positive revenue for this quarter. And the other company that is down at the moment is HD Supplies. At this moment, the company is down over 2%, and I think they're going to report positive EPS and revenue. And the next company is Dave & Buster's. They are actually up 21%, and this is one of the stocks that I actually like. I actually have been to Dave & Buster's, and it is fun. And let me tell you, the only thing that they are missing is they need to expand a little bit more, because it is very challenging to find a Dave & Buster's nearby. So in my opinion, this company is going to report positive revenue and EPS. And I wish they would expand more, because they actually have a good business. Or maybe they are expanding a little bit more, but not at a faster pace, which is what I really would like to. And the next company caught my eye, that is Brown Forman Corporation. They're over almost 17% for the year, but the reason why it caught my eye, because there was a story this week that Constellation Brands was gonna buy them out. Now, Constellation Brand is one of the stocks that I'm actually investing. And the stock actually went down when the news came out. And it did recover the next day. So I wasn't worried that it was going to go down just based on those rumors. Now, Brown Forman Corporation does the Jack Daniels and those type of liquors. And Brown Corporation is going to post positive EPS and revenue. And the next company is J.M. Smucker. And they have a jelly, peanut butter, but they have a lot of good products. Now they're only up 1.91% for the year. And then Smucker is going to come out with more products. And the products are actually good, but it's very competitive in that type of space. And the next company is Vail Resort. And that company has been up for almost 34%. And that's a resort company. And I think they're going to post good EPS, but it's going to go down in the revenue. Now, I don't have a strong opinion on this because I have never invested into a hotel or a resort. And the last company is Verifone System, and they're up almost 6%. And Verifone System is a product where it's a point of sales product. It's kind of like Apple Pay. I think they're going to report bad revenue and EPS. Right now, like I said earlier, the stock is only up 6%, and I think it's going to pull back a little bit. The challenging part of this company is that it's competing a lot of services like Apple Pay, PayPal, Square. So there's a lot of competitors for this space. However, like I said always, this is just an informational video. You can make your own choice to invest into any of the companies mentioned in this video. That is going to be your choice. Well, that is going to be everything for the video. Please make sure that you check out the giveaway video. It's very simple, like I mentioned earlier. Just put a comment, and the video is only like 3 minutes. It's very short. And I did the video about the top 5 stocks during the month of June right here. You can actually check it out if you want to get more information about those stocks. Make sure that you subscribe to the Financial Information Channel. I'm going to bring you more videos about how to invest in the stock market, personal finance, and like this type of videos where I do the recap about the stock market, and so you can see what earnings are going to be reported for the next week. And once again, thanks for watching. Have an excellent day and take care, my friends.